So I have my Lunt 40 on my CEM 40 mount here just for stabilization, and I have an issue with the helical focuser here. So this isn't my first helical focuser. I actually have an SV Boney 60mm guide scope that I use that also ran into this problem a while ago where the focuser just became loose. You can see that I can move it a little bit. It does kind of come out, but it slides and slips. And the reason is that there are some screws here that lock it into place that became loose over time. And for me, over time was literally just three times in the field. So I was able to fix this, and I had to loosen it again because I realized that the zero marker here wasn't actually aligned to where the line is here. So I had to loosen it up again so that I can align it out again. So to do this, you have to peel back this rubber housing here for the helical focuser. And you can do this with your finger. You can use like a screwdriver if you want. I try not to do that so I don't scratch this up. And you'll see that there are like tiny screwdrivers or screws all around the focuser here. See it? It's right there. There's a tiny one. It's about a millimeter across or so. And there are a bunch of them. I'm just gonna pull these down so that I can see them all. And there we go. It's pretty loose. It does come out. The one with my SV Boney, it's all exposed, so I don't have to pull anything down. But anyways, the way to fix this is to use a small screwdriver. So I actually have this 0.9mm flathead screwdriver that I used to astromod my DSLR well over a year ago. And I still have it, and I never thought I'd find a use for this again, but I do. I did, and this fits perfectly into the screw on the Lunt 40. You could buy this pack from Amazon. It has a bunch of other small screwdrivers as well. I'll link to this in the description below. It's actually been pretty useful, even the bigger ones with other projects. But anyways, zoomed back in, I'm going to first align the white marker with the zero here. So you'd have to make sure that, you know, this is, the focuser is all the way in. If it's not all the way in, what you want to do is just tighten this, make sure you can turn the focuser, put it all the way in, loosen it again, and then tighten it again on the zero. If you don't care about precise measurement, then you could leave it alone. So I'm just going to use the screwdriver, and I'm going to tighten this. Okay, so it's tightened, and the zero aligns up with the line here, so now I can get some precise measurement. The reason that it perfectly lines up, this screw perfectly lines up with these and what you see on the screen, is because, as I mentioned earlier, I had to loosen it because I noticed that I didn't align the zero and the line when I fixed it out in the field. I was just in a hurry, just wanted to get it working. There are other, so now you can see that it focuses, it's not slipping anymore. And there are other screws all over this. I think there's, let's see if we count, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 screws all around this. So you wanna make sure that they're all tight when you're, if you have issues with this, and that this focuser should work. And when you're done with this, just put the rubber grip back to where it was, it just slips right back, falls into place. So preferably I would have gotten the feather touch focuser if it was available. Maybe one day I'll upgrade the feather touch focuser or get a bigger Lunt 40 since I love this one so much. And of course, when you're done focusing, make sure you use this knob here to lock the focus into place so that it stays locked in. You know, it is friction based, so you can force it, but don't. You don't want to scratch the insides here. If you run into the same problem, let me know. I'm just curious if, you know, other Lunt products, other Lunt helical focusers are doing the same thing. And as I mentioned, this isn't really Lunt specific. It could happen with any helical focuser. I'm just surprised that it happened so quickly with the Lunt. Anyways, I wish you great views of the sun, clear skies.